Jerusalem, to observe with great devotion the days of our Lord's passion and resurrection, and to prepare for the same by a season of penitence and fasting. This season of Lent provided also a time in which converts to the faith were prepared for holy baptism. There was also a time when such persons as had, by reason of notorious sins, been separated from the body of the faithful, were reconciled and restored to the fellowship of the church by penitence and forgiveness. Thereby the whole congregation was put in mind the message of pardon and absolution contained in the gospel of our Savior, and of the need which all Christians continually have of a renewal of their repentance and faith. I therefore invite you in the name of the Church to the observance of a holy Lent by self-examination and repentance, by prayer, fasting, and self-denial, and by reading and meditation upon God's holy word. Please remain standing for the praises, and afterwards for Psalm 51. You may sit or kneel.
O Lord, open thou our lips,
and our shall show forth thy praise.
O Lord, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be.
first reading. Lesson from Joel 2, verse 12 to 18. Therefore also now, saith the Lord, turn ye even to me with all your heart, and with fasting, and with weeping, and with mourning, and render your heart and not your garments, and turn unto the Lord your God. For he is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, and of great kindness, and repenteth him of the evil. Who knoweth if he will return, and repent, and leave a blessing behind him, even a meat offering and a drink offering unto the Lord your God? Blow the trumpet in Zion, sanctify a fast, call a solemn assembly, gather the people, sanctify the congregation, assemble the elders, gather the children, and those that suck the breast. Let the bridegroom go forth of his chamber, and the bride out of her closet. Let the priests, the ministers of the Lord, weep between the porch and the altar, and let them say, spare not thy people, O Lord, and give not thine heritage to reproach, that the heathen should rule over them. Wherefore should they say amongst the people, where is their God? Then will the Lord be jealous for his land and pity his people.
Oh,
written in the Gospel according to St. Matthew, beginning on the first verse of its fifth chapter. And seeing the multitudes, he went up into a mountain. When he was set, his disciples came unto him. And he opened his mouth and taught them, saying, Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. Blessed are they which are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Here ends the lesson.
Thank you.
Please be seated for the end. Finally,
word about the prayers. First prayer will be a prayer written by Alexander for the people of Ukraine. And I also would remind you all of the prayer vigil tomorrow evening, 5:30, in this chapel. Let us pray.
Dear Lord, let us pray for those who are experiencing traumatizing events, particularly those who are caught in the middle in Ukraine. We pray that they find strength, safety wherever they flee to. We pray also for the soldiers and men on both sides being drafted to fight. May God bless them with courage and strength to hold up until peace can be restored. We pray for the children who are experiencing their families torn apart by war. We pray for the people who will be affected economically both inside and out of the conflict. We also pray for those experiencing sickness, pain, poverty, and we pray for everyone to find strength and to endure and bravely, and for those to help. And we pray for the dead. We pray that humanity is able to find forgiveness. We hope and pray that all evil will be eradicated and that a new generation will learn from the mistakes of the past. Amen.
Let us pray, O most mighty God and merciful Father, who hast compassion upon all, and hatest nothing that thou hast made, who wouldest not the death of the sinner, but that he should rather turn from her sin and be saved, mercifully forgive our trespasses, receive and comfort us, who are grieved and weary with the burden of our sins. Thy property is always to have mercy, to the only and appropriate to forgive sins. Spare, O Lord, spare thy people whom thou hast redeemed. Enter not into judgment with thy servants who truly repent us of our faults. But so make haste to help us in this world, that we may ever live with thee in the world to come. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
On page 10 we pray together. Turn us, O good God, and so shall we be turned. Be favorable, O Lord, be favorable to thy people, who turn to thee in weeping, fasting, and praying. For thou art a merciful God, full of compassion, long-suffering, and of great pity. Thou sparest when we deserve punishment, and in thy wrath thinkest upon mercy. Spare thy people, good Lord, spare them. Hear us, O Lord, for thy mercy is great, and according to the multitude of thy mercies, look upon us through the merit and mediation of thy blessed Son, Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Continue to pray together. Lord, for thy tender mercy's sake, lay not our sins to our charge, but forgive that is past, and give us grace to amend our sinful lives, to decline from sin and incline to virtue, that we may walk with a perfect heart before thee, now and evermore. Remember that dust thou art, and unto dust shalt thou return.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we, knowing we are but dust,
and that for our unworthiness unto dust shall we return, may through thy mercy be found meet to receive forgiveness of all our sins and those good things which thou hast promised to the penitent, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Remember, dust